Yolanda Love.
Who made up a name like that?
Does it matter?
Not to me. How tall are you, Yolanda?
With heels, I'm 5'10". Without, 5'7".
And you're Norwegian? Swedish?
Originally.
Nobody could ever accuse you of talking too much, could they?
I've never found it necessary.
Maybe I can help you now, Yolanda. Who sent you that statue? The one in your dressing room, the naked figure, the frightened girl.
I haven't got a statue in my dressing room.
The one on the shelf, you told me to be careful with it.
Sometimes, I don't know how to tell you this, but sometimes I can't remember things. So good. There's nothing wrong with me, Esther.
You're much better than you were 6 months ago, Virginia.
Will I leave you soon and go back to dancing?
Would that make you happy?
Yes. How can I ever thank you for all you've done for me?
We're in trouble and we've got to leave.
You told me I was all right. You told me everything would be all right.
I thought I could help you. I didn't know that you'd disobey me and keep that fetish and use it for some kind of ritual.
I got rid of it.
You still have it. Your mania is fixed on it. And if anybody else knows you have it, you'll be arrested. Now get it for me.
No! You tried to kill me before. You're taking her away from me.
The way we always meet up in the same old place. Where there's an old saying that dead men don't talk.
That's why they're dead.
Anything else?
Let me go!
I want that diamond.
Oh, which diamond is that, ma'am?
The Tirana Blue. It belongs to me legally.
Why don't you stop this chasing around and go back to New York, where a couple of million guys will chase after you?
You're really concerned about me. Sweet.
This is no silly little game we're playing. We're dealing cards with a man who's committed two murders.
I want to see he doesn't commit another one. Besides, there's only one diamond we can't both end up with.
No?
No.
It might be amusing to try, though.
I told the listeners and the viewers of Flemish television how very international you were. Now, please, could you give us the outline of your story?
I didn't understand a word you were saying to begin with.
No, but I just told you, you're very international. I believe you're from Swedish descent, aren't you?
Yes, I'm born in Sweden, yes, mm-hmm. But I've been living in America for 7 years. Mm-hmm. Almost 7 years.
And you went right into the pictures?
Yes, about 2 months after I arrived in America. Mm-hmm. But I had some difficulties, of course, for 3 years or so. Firstly, because mm-hmm. I didn't speak any English at all. Mm-hmm. And also, I had no experience in acting.
No. And would you care to talk us a bit about those first pictures, or don't you?
Well, I didn't do very much. I was signed up to a contract at a studio. And they used me more or less as an extra. Mm-hmm. No parts or any pictures that I was making alone at all.
Go away. Leave her alone.
Mr. Bascom, where are you? Oh, there you are.
Come back here.
Mr. Bascom. Mr. Bascom, don't you know it isn't nice to annoy ladies? I'm awfully sorry, ma'am, but you see, oh. It's you. Live. Not on film and not a kinescope, but in the flesh. And all my flesh. When I dreamed of meeting you, and I dreamed of your hair, and your nose, and your lips, and your chin, and your eyes, and your fingertips. We're gonna be neighbors.
Neighbors? I just moved.
We can share the same incinerator. Just think, I can deliver my letters in person.
No way, you crazy.
Oh, wait, oh! 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 What are you doing? Anita! That's Anita! She fell in! I'm gonna go in and save her. I can't swim, but we'll both die together.
All right, and then afterwards you went from America. You're in Europe just now, I believe.
Yes, now I've just finished a picture in Rome, El Signo di Roma, mm-hmm. The Sign of Rome. And it took us, in fact, 3 months. It's a mm-hmm. historical picture.
Could you tell us some more about The Sign of Rome?
Well, it's a historical picture that happened 300 years after Christ. Mm-hmm. And I'm the queen of Palmyra, which is a part, or was a part, mm-hmm. of Syria. And I go into war with the Romans. I break the mm-hmm. peace treaty
this
that I had
to do,
with know. The Romans. Well, in the end of it, or in the beginning, I take one of the generals, the Roman generals, I take them prisons, and afterwards we become very friendly. I, in fact, fall in love with him, and I take him in as one of my generals in my army, and we plan and plot the battle scenes mm-hmm. with this general, and I let him in on all the secrets as he's going to take my battles into mm-hmm. the war. Mm-hmm. But the night before the big battle, he escapes my tents and goes back to the Romans and then moves his army against mine, mm-hmm. and therefore he double-crossed me mm-hmm. and they take me prisoner. Mm-hmm. But it all ends up very well in the end.
Thank you very much for having been so kind to come to here and to give us this interview. And we hope that you'll be very successful in your career. Thank you so much,
and thank you for having me here.
You're very kind.
we said, hey, Anita, would you turn your head?
Yes, I would turn my head.
You want to say it all together?
Anita Ekberg.
That's right.
Miss Ekberg, will you say goodnight to the family?
You already played the part of a dancing girl, of a princess, of a queen. Is that the kind of parts you want to play? Haven't you other ambitions than historical?
Yes, of course, parts? Of course. I don't choose historical parts. I'd much prefer to have a modern story, mm-hmm. very dramatic. And I'm really looking forward for one.
Haven't you found something already?
Not yet. I have a chance in Federico Fellini. Mm-hmm. He's making a picture in February. And the part that I'm supposed to play, or that I might be playing, is modern and it's dramatic. Mm-hmm. And it's a step forward to what I want to read.
To be just a flicker on the silent screen.